Welcome back to part three of this tutorial on our Resolve to Adobe Premiere proxy workflow. If you're not sure where we are, check out the previous videos in this playlist. Also, feel free to check out the description box below for chapter markers and jump to the sections you need. Okay, we're back. We finished the render of this camera card. And as you can see, I've got this lovely little folder that has all of my rendered ProRes proxy files here. And also the ALE that I created, the metadata ALE that I created. So now I'm going to pop over into Premiere and get this stuff all linked up. Okay, so I'm going to create a brand new project in Premiere. And here I've got a one screen layout so that we can all see everything. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to import the ALE, which is the metadata file that we created. So as you can see, it's imported this. Now, this is just like basically an empty metadata file. There are no media files attached to it. But you can see that I've got a bunch of unlinked clips here. I have the frame rate. I have all the time code in there. And you can also look through some of the other metadata, and you can see the tape name is the real name that we assigned back in Resolve. The description is whatever I chose to put in. And then also the good takes. Remember, I did like a couple of good takes as an example. So that came through. You can see the ones that I checked off. And then also there is, I haven't turned on the comments field, but if I turn on comments, you will see the LUT info that I put in. There we go. So I put the LUT info. So that's all of that metadata that we created is coming across in this ALE file. And now what I just need to do is I just need to relink these clips, these empty clips, to the actual clips that I made. So I'm going to select all of them and I'm going to click Link Media. And then I'm going to use Premiere to navigate to where I saved the media. And click OK, and it should find all of them. And now we've got all of our lovely clips right here and ready to go. One thing you will notice is that they do come through as MXF because the ALE was exported from the Resolve timeline and those files were actually MXF files. So even though these are MOV files, they still come up as the name MXF. I'm not bothered by it. I mean, you can go through if you want, you can rename them and take off the MXF suffix. By the way, if you like this content, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comments what other content you might like to see. So here we are, we're all ready to go. And I'm gonna take us through the next step, which is to sync our audio. So I'm just gonna do a little project organization here. I'm gonna make a new bin. I'm gonna call this A002 so that everything is here. And then I'm gonna import the audio from the day that they shot this. Okay, so here are all my audio files from that day, and I'm just gonna use Premiere's like really easy auto-syncing feature to link up the audio with the video that matches. So I have more audio than I have video because actually this day they shot a bunch of video cards, but that doesn't really matter. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create one more bin. And this is just my personal way of doing it where I create a little sync bin. And then I drag everything into the sync bin. And that way I can drag it back when I'm done. And so I can just sync one card at a time and keep everything organized. So that's an audio report. We don't need that. So I'm going to select all of these that are in the bin. And I know that's like this footage is from the same day as this audio. I'm going to right click. And then I'm going to create a multi-camera source sequence. And then Premiere is going to ask me how to do that. So we can do it by in points or out points if we were doing it manually. You could do it by sound time code if you had that information, or you can do it by time code, which is what I'm going to do because they had a synced time code with the audio and the video. And then some of these settings down here you can just take a look at and see what applies to you. You want to move the source clips to the process clips bin. I find this to be a really good organizational piece and is really helpful. So I leave this checked off. And then for the camera names, we're going to use the clip names. And I'm going to click OK. And now it says it could not synchronize one or more clips because a match could not be found. That's pretty normal because usually there's like at least one or two camera files that are maybe a false take that don't have audio in them. And I also know that there are a bunch of audio clips here that are like wild clips or clips from other camera rolls that aren't in this project. So I know that that's normal. I'm going to click OK. And as you can see, it's created for us. Just make this big so you can see it. These multi-camera clips. And then anything that was included in the multi-camera clips goes into process clips. So these are all of the video and audio clips that the program was able to sync up. And anything outside of this are video and audio clips that the program was not able to sync up. So to keep this tidy, I'm going to take all of this audio that was unused and put it back in my audio bin. And then I'm just going to have a look through and check out all of the clips that it made for me and see whether or not they make sense. So I'm just going to go through each one. I'm going to check the slate and make sure that it looks good to me. Make sure the sync seems on. And I do that for all of them. I see that there's a couple where it didn't sync up. Well, that's clearly like some kind of VFX plate. Yep, I've got a tail slate here. And then this other one is probably, this is clearly a false take. But the rest of these have worked pretty well. Now, if you were to find something where you thought the audio wasn't quite right, then all you have to do is you can right click and open it in the timeline. And now what you've done is you've opened your multicam clip into the Premiere timeline, and you can adjust how the audio is lined up. So if you felt like the clapper wasn't right and you wanted to like move it over a few frames, then you just move it over and then just save it. And then now it's moved over. Like, it's so easy to just kind of quickly resync anything that you want to resync. I'm just going to put that back though, because it was actually fine. You're mostly ready to go. The next step, obviously, that I would take from here would be to rename these files based on the slate, because this is something that I, as an editor, or if I was an assistant doing it for an editor, they would probably want me to do, because no one really wants to see these clip names be here. And the great thing about this method that Premiere has used is that the original clips are always referenceable inside the process clips bin. So I'm not actually changing the names of the camera clips themselves, and I'm not actually changing the names of the audio clips. I'm only changing the name of the group clip, which just kind of points to those clips. So once you get down to the end of the project and you're doing deliveries for sound and picture, there's never going to be any concern that you've like renamed something that they're not now going to be able to access the proper name of, because we're just renaming the multicam clip, and it's super, super easy. So I'm just going to go through and I'm going to rename these based on the slate. That one is nothing. False. Okay, this is interesting. So I've opened up this one and it thinks it's got two cameras in here, even though I'm pretty sure this is only one camera. So I'm going to open this up in the timeline and see what's going on. And so what's happened is there was like a little bit of a false start here. They started the camera, shut it off, and then turned it back on again here. So Premiere has identified it as like two different cameras and put them on separate tracks so that they don't compete with each other. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to move this down to this one track and delete this top track here. And now when it comes up, what it'll do is it'll turn on for a sec, it'll turn back off, and it'll turn back on, but it's still all in one camera clip instead of being two cameras. So that's it. So you just go through all your clips, organize them however you like, organize them however the editor likes, do all the other stuff that you would do, add locators, organize them into bins, all of that good stuff. And your match back to resolve is going to also work really well, I promise. I will do in a future video the next step of this, which would be to take an edited timeline from Premiere and bring it into resolve for color correction. So I'll bring that to you guys next time. That's it for this one. If you have questions, you can pop them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer. Thanks for watching.